Mark Scheifele, Patrick Laine, and Mason Appleton all out with injuries for game two. Jansen Harkins draws into the lineup first period. He takes the pass from Adam Lowry and then scores his first career playoff goal in his first playoff game. Harkins played in 29 games this season, 1-0 Jets through one. Second period, now 2-0. Nikolaj Ehlers turns it over to Elias Lindholm, and he beats Connor Hellebuyck. That's the first even-strength goal that he has given up in this series. Then late in the second period, Sam Bennett fires it on net, follows it up with a wraparound attempt. It goes off Nathan Beaulieu's skate and in. Flames scoring three during the second period in game one, two in this one to tie it. Early third, Kyle Connor picks off Derek Forbert's pass.
Derek Forbert sends it across, ripped by Connor. He's got a break along with Wheeler. Kyle Connor, oh, what a stop. Did you see that?
Cam Talbot keeps the game tied at twos, and earlier in the game, Ehlers gave Matthew Tkachuk the fake slash from the bench, and in the third, Ehlers goes right back at Tkachuk, knocks him down, and takes an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. It sends Calgary to the power play on the ensuing man advantage. Milan Lucic has a look at an open net, but Hellebuyck gets the paddle down to keep this game tied at two. Then later in the frame, Jets on the power play. Ehlers tips the point shot past Talbot, scores his first career postseason goal as the Jets tie up the series one game apiece, 3-2 the final in this one. It took Ehlers 23 postseason games to finally light the lamp. He previously only had 7 assists, all coming back in the 2017-18 postseason. Sam Bennett's second period goal gives him at least one goal in each of his 4 postseason runs with Calgary.
That's not usually my spot on the power play, but, I was in there. I know what I need to do in there. And I was lucky enough to get a stick on that puck. So it felt great, but like you said, you learn every single game, whether it's preseason, regular season, or playoffs.
You need guys to step up, and it's not a great situation when you're filling in for Mark Scheifele and Patrick Laine. But I think those guys that all came in with a ton of excitement, guys haven't seen the ice in quite a while, and to be thrust into a huge game like that is very exciting for them.
We approach the game like that. We approach every game knowing that we have a real good chance to win. I think you look at the way our team's built, and the amount of skill we have up front and the quality guys we have on the back end, and you have a world-class goalie in net who gives you a chance to win every night. So we knew this was a really important game, and to get us right back in the series, and we're looking forward to game three tomorrow.
Blake, can you give us a sense of what was said after the second period? Obviously, you guys were you didn't have the 2-goal lead anymore, but you were still in a good spot. Your team's been composed all year. What was it like in the room?
What are we gonna do with the 2-goal lead? That's too easy for us. You know what I mean? It was that type of game, and I think that we were invested in whatever it was gonna take to get a win tonight. Obviously losing a 2-goal lead, it didn't feel like there was any letdown in our group. There was no disappointment. Our mindset was just finding a way to get that next goal.
The end of the playoffs with the loss that we took and the players that were out. But it ties more, Mike, into the year that we've had. I mean, we've just been in this situation so many times. So it's going to be top five for me.
We knew it wasn't going to be easy. We didn't take them lightly. Obviously, there was a great opportunity for us, but all we can do now is look at the next one. It was a hard-fought game. I thought we battled hard to get back tied, and fortunately, we came out on the wrong end tonight, but we'll get right back at it tomorrow.